There's some well-documented flood events that have been recorded in this area, such as Dry Creek and the Doe River. They have both experienced flooding over the past 10 to 25 years. I believe it was 1998 was a really big one on the Doe River. And even the Doe River had a lot of pretty serious flooding. That's not an area we've really looked at or focused on as much, but Hampton, Roan Mountain experienced a lot of flooding with the Doe, but it's a much smaller watershed, so the flow rate wasn't nearly what we saw on the Nolichucky. It's so much beyond what we had seen in this area, and so the scale of it, I think, is really pretty astounding. When you had those types of events, like for example, the Doe River flood or the Dry Creek flood, they were related to much smaller systems, either frontal systems or thunderstorms that dumped a ton of rain, but on a smaller area. And so you didn't have just this widespread multi-county, multi-state impact. Helene, with how huge it was, and then the frontal system right before it that really primed the area, wet the soil, dumped a huge amount of rain itself, which alone would have been a big storm. And then you had Helene come in right after it, and really they worked together to funnel tons of moisture, so much more moisture than you would expect coming into North Carolina and our part of Tennessee. And so all of those factors together made it just kind of the perfect storm for something like this. A very, very rare and very extreme event.